experimental verification of matter waves. That is Davison and Germer experiment. In 1924, Davison and Germer gave the first experimental evidence for the de Broglie hypothesis. So, de Broglie hypothesis already we discussed in our previous class. So, I am giving pen option. One second. Right. So, you see, in 1924, de Broglie extended his hypothesis, dual nature of radiation to dual nature of the matter. But in 1927, Davison and Germer gave the first experimental evidence to the de Broglie hypothesis, that is matter waves. That is matter waves. What is the principle of this Davison and Germer experiment? What is the principle? So, what is the principle of this Davison and Germer experiment? So, the matter waves accelerated in terms of electron beam can be used for diffraction studies in crystals. This is the principle. So, if the wavelength of an electron is equal to the order of X-rays wavelength, then like X-rays, a beam of electrons must show diffraction effect, diffraction effects from a crystal. Hence, in this experiment, accelerated electron beam can be used for diffraction studies in this crystal. That is the working principle. So, accelerated electrons are used is the working principle. Accelerated electron beam can be used for diffraction studies in this crystal is the working principle of Davison and Germer experiment. So, in Davison and Germer experiment, this is the filament F. So, this filament F is connected to low tension battery. So, this is a positive terminal, this is a negative terminal of the battery. So, this is low tension battery, So, using the low tension battery from connected to low tension battery filter, that is electron gun F. The filter F is connected to low tension battery. It is behaves as a electron gun. So, the filter is connected to low tension battery. From the electron gun, electron beam is produced. So, I am erasing this one, right? Electron beam is produced. This electron beam is allowed to fall on the pinhole cylinder. So, this is the pinhole cylinder. This pinhole cylinder is connected to high tension battery. So, this is negative term. This is the positive terminal. This is negative, positive, negative. So, this is positive, negative. It is connected to the filter F. Then the cylinder C, from the cylinder C, a perfect electron beam is produced. This electron beam is allowed to fall on the crystal. So target, this is the target is the nickel crystal. So around this nickel crystal, a semicircular scale is arranged. This semicircular scale has a This semicircular scale has a C dash, this is Faraday collector. Faraday collector. So it is connected to galvanometer. So this galvanometer is connected to earthing. So this total experiment is placed in a chamber. The total experiment placed in a chamber. Clearly, you can see here that experiment. You can see here. So experimental arrangement, the experimental arrangement is shown in this figure. The filament F, this is the filament. Filament F is connected to low tension battery. Low tension battery. From the low tension battery, so this is the electron gun. The electron beam is produced. It is allowed to fall on the pinhole cylinder C. Pinhole cylinder C. This pinhole cylinder is connected to high tension battery. Pinhole cylinder is connected to high tension battery. So from this high tension battery, a perfect electron beam or narrow electron beam is produced. So from this high tension battery, we can supply the 54 volts voltage through the cylinder C. From the cylinder C, a perfect electron beam is produced. The electron beam is allowed to fall on the nickel crystal. Nickel crystal. Around this nickel crystal, a semicircular scale is arranged. The semicircular scale has Faraday cylinder C dash. The total experiment is placed in a chamber, vacuum chamber. Vacuum chamber. This experiment consists of three main parts. Number one, electron gun. Number two, target. Number three, circular scale arrangement. Electron gun. So this is number one point. Electron gun. So this is the target. Nickel target. So circular scale, semicircular scale. This is the semicircular scale you can see on the screen. It consists of three parts. They are electron gun, target setup, and circular scale arrangement. Circular scale arrangement. The whole experiment is kept in a vacuum chamber. The job of electron gun is to produce a fine beam of electrons of required velocity. It consists of filament F. So low tension battery, high tension battery, and pinhole provides in the cylinder C. Cylinder C. So working. What is the working of this experiment? Davison and Germer experiment. Davison and Germer experiment. So you see here working. When tungsten filament F is heated, tungsten filament F is heated using the low tension battery. When tungsten filament F is heated by low tension battery, electrons are produced in electron gun. The electrons are produced from the electron gun. These electrons are accelerated to a desired velocity by applying suitable potential 54 volts from high tension battery HTB. Using this high tension battery, you clearly see we can supply 54 volts. What I am saying, when tungsten filament is heated by low tension battery, the electrons are produced in electron gun. This electron beam is allowed to fall on the pinhole cylinder C. The pinhole cylinder is connected to high tension battery. High tension battery. Using this high tension battery, we can supply 54 volts through the cylinder C. Then from the cylinder C, the narrow beam of electrons emerging from a system of pinholes providing in the cylinder C. What I am saying, from the cylinder C, a perfect narrow electron beam is produced. The fast moving narrow beam of electron is made to strike the target, nickel target of single crystal perpendicularly to the nickel single crystal. The electrons are scattered. The incident electron beam is incident on the nickel target. These are scattered. All the electrons are scattered or reflected in all the possible directions by the atoms of nickel crystal. In the circular scale arrangement, so it has circular scale arrangement, you can observe clearly. In the circular scale arrangement, Faraday cylinder C dash is arranged. So C dash is there. It is moved over the circular scale. The cylinder C dash, Faraday cylinder, can move along the circular scale. Using Faraday cylinder C dash as collector, it collects all the scattered electrons. Collector. The intensity of scattered electrons is measured in all the directions. The collector C dash is capable of rotation about an axis, passing through the point of incident of electrons on the crystal. Thus, the intensity of the scattered beam can be determined as a function of the scattered angle phi. Scattered angle phi. So scattered angle phi, the different scattered angle values we can take on the the Faraday cylinder. First you see Faraday cylinder has two walls which are insulated from each other. A retarding potential is maintained between them. So that only fast moving electron coming from the electron gun may enter into the secondary electrons. The secondary electrons, if any generated at the surface of nickel, are stopped by the retarding potential. Thus, the galvanometer connected to Faraday cylinder C dash shows deflection due to electrons from the electron gun. So what I am saying, clearly you observe, simply it is very, very, very simple. You can write in your own words. Just listen. So this tungsten filament is connected to low tension battery B1. From this B1 or electron gun, electron beam is produced. It is allowed to fall on the pinhole cylinder. The pinhole cylinder C is connected to high tension battery B2. Using the high tension battery, we can supply the voltage 54 volts to the cylinder C. Then from the cylinder C, a perfect narrow electron beam is produced. It is allowed to fall on the nickel crystal or nickel target. So the incident electrons are scattered in all the directions, are reflected in all the directions. But some electrons collects this C dash Faraday cylinder. It behaves as a collector. That is called Faraday collector. The Faraday collector C dash cylinder has two walls. You see clearly it has two walls, which are insulated with each other. Insulated with each other. Between these two walls, some retarded potential is produced. Retarded potential is produced. This retarded potential stops all the unnecessary secondary electrons. The retarded potential stops all the unnecessary secondary electrons. But all the scattered, some perfect intensity electrons collects the C dash collector, and the electrons are moving through this. We can observe the deflection in galvanometer. So for different intensity values, we can calculate the phi value. We can calculate the scattered angle phi value. So the intensity, this is the working. So the intensity values take on y-axis, and the scattered electron beam occurred angle phi take on x-axis. So the graph we can observe like this, like this. So the high intensity peak we can observe at phi is equal to 50 degrees. At voltage V is equal to 54 volts. 54 volts you can observe clearly up to here. You can observe clearly up to here. So the atomic rows of nickel crystal act like a ruling of diffraction grating. So it behaves like a grating. Thus, the crystal 1-1 plane of FCC nickel at V is equal to 54 volts at phi is equal to scattered angle phi is equal to 50 degrees. So angle theta, where theta is called Bragg angle or glancing angle or angle of diffraction. So these are the atoms, regular periodic arrangement of atoms. The above figure I am drawing here as it is. These are the regular periodic arrangement of atoms. Regular. So these are the crystal planes. Crystal planes. You can observe in this figure. Crystal planes. So some electron beam is incident on the 1-1-1 plane. 1-1 plane. So this is the scattered angle. Scattered. So between this, what is this? Phi. Phi is equal to 50 degrees. Phi is equal to 50 degrees. From here to here, this is the diffraction angle theta. This is also diffraction angle theta. From this figure, theta plus theta. Theta plus phi. What is that angle? From here to here, what is this angle? This is 180 degrees. So it is equal to 180 degrees. Theta plus theta, 2 theta plus phi is equal to 180 degrees. So 2 theta plus what is phi? 50 degrees. So this is equal to 180 degrees. 2 theta is equal to 180 minus 50. 180 minus 50, that is 130. So 2 theta is equal to 130. Theta is equal to 130 by 2, that is 65 degrees. So Bragg angle theta is equal to 45 degrees. For nickel, FCC, face-centered cubic structure, 1-1 plane. Interplanar distance. For nickel, the standard interplanar spacing value is D is equal to 0.91 angstroms. So according to Bragg's law, we know formula 2D sine theta is equal to n lambda. Substituting all the values 2, so D 0.91 sine 65 degrees into 1. So n, this is order of diffraction 1. Order of diffraction 1. So 1 into lambda. You can see here, substituting all the values. So this is 2 into 0.91. This is sine 65 degrees. You can see in your calculator 0.908. Lambda is equal to 1.65 angstroms. The wavelength of electron using de Broglie relation. You know very well this formula in angstroms. Lambda is equal to 12.27 by root V angstroms. But what is the voltage value using high tension battery? 54 volts. So substituting here at the place of V, so we get lambda is equal to 1.67 angstroms. Angstroms. So this is equation 1. This is equation 2. From equation 1 and 2, as the two values are in good agreement. So 1.67. So nearly, so this decimal, nearly difference 0.02 angstroms. It is very less. So it is good agreement. So hence, this experiment confirms the de Broglie concept of matter waves. So this is the first experimental evidence to de Broglie hypothesis. First experimental evidence to de Broglie hypothesis. You listen clearly. Again, this is very, very, very important essay. You don't worry about this. Very simple. You learn here. So in 1927, Davison and Germer gave the first experimental evidence for the de Broglie hypothesis or de Broglie matter waves. What I am saying, in 1927, de Broglie gave the first experimental evidence for the de Broglie hypothesis. De Broglie hypothesis. So what is the principle of Davison and Germer experiment? The electrons are accelerated, or accelerated electron beam can be used for diffraction studies in this crystal. This is the working principle. This is the working principle. So experimental arrangement. Experimental arrangement. The experimental arrangement is shown in this figure. Clearly you observe it consists three parts. They are electron gun, electron gun, target. This is the nickel target, and circular scale. So this is the circular scale. It consists three main parts: electron gun, target, circular scale arrangement. So arrangement, that is construction and working, you can write in your own words. You see, this is the tungsten filament. This tungsten filament is connected to low tension battery B1. So cylinder C is connected to high tension battery. What I am saying, construction. Construction. So filament F is connected to low tension battery B1. Low tension battery B1. At a small distance, let us take a cylinder, pinhole cylinder C. The pinhole cylinder C is connected to high tension battery B2. Using this high tension battery, we can supply the voltage 54 volts. At a small distance, let us take a target, that is a nickel single crystal target. Target. Around this nickel single crystal, a semicircular scale arrangement is arranged. The scale has C dash Faraday cylinder or Faraday collector. The whole experiment is kept in a vacuum chamber. This is the vacuum chamber. The whole experiment kept in a vacuum chamber. So what is the working? What is the working of this experiment? Using the low tension battery, if we are heating the filament F from the electron gun, electron beam is produced. This electron beam is allowed to fall on the pinhole cylinder C. The pinhole cylinder C is connected to high tension battery. Using high tension battery, if you are supplying 54 volts through the cylinder C, a perfect narrow electron beam is produced. It is allowed to fall on the target, nickel crystal Ni target. The incident electrons are scattered in all the directions, are reflected in all the directions. The reflected or scattered electrons are collected using Faraday collector. Sometimes they scattered unnecessary secondary electrons. So between this C dash, it has two layers. Between these two layers, some retarded potential is produced. Retarded potential is produced. This retarded potential stops all the unnecessary secondary electrons. So the perfect scattered electrons collects and move over the semicircular scale. From this moving, we can observe the different scattered angles. For this different scattered angles, we can collect the different electrons intensities. Different intensities. Then take an x-axis phi value, take an y-axis intensity value. Intensity value. You can see on the figure. This is the figure. You take on x-axis phi, scattered angle, electron beam scattered angle. This is electron incident intensity values. So at potential V is equal to 54 volts, we observe the high intensity scattered angle 50 degrees. So you can take here. Let us take a regular periodic arrangement of nickel crystal. Nickel crystal. The nickel crystal interplanar spacing value 0.91 angstroms, standard values, you remember. The incident electron is incident at n is equal to 1 plane, 111 plane. You see here, 111 plane. So all the values, substituting in Bragg's law, 2d sin theta is equal to n lambda. So 2 into 0.91 sine 65 degrees. How can we get 65 degrees? You see, from this figure, so this is theta, this is theta, this is phi. Phi is equal to 50 degrees. From here to here, this is 180 degrees. So this is theta plus phi plus theta is equal to 180 degrees. You observe clearly here. So 2 theta plus 50, theta plus theta, what is that? 2 theta plus 50 is equal to 180 degrees. 2 theta is equal to 180 minus 50, that is 130. So theta is equal to 130 by 2, 65 degrees. So this theta, I am substituting here. Sine 65 is equal to, n is equal to 1, first order. So lambda as it is. Lambda as it is. According to Bragg's law, 2d sine theta is equal to n lambda. Substituting all the values, we get lambda value 1.65 angstroms. The wavelength of electron using de Broglie relation. So this is the lambda is equal to 12.27 by root V angstroms. But V value 54 volts. So we get lambda is equal to 1.67. As the two values are in good agreement, hence this experiment confirms the de Broglie concept of matter waves. We can say that the Davison and Germer gave the first experimental evidence to the de Broglie hypothesis or matter waves.